So we're going to Starbucks, and we have a special guest with us.
Bekah.
We're here in Starbucks right now, hanging out.
Because you can't do a youth vlog without going to Starbucks. And plus, Bekah doesn't like Starbucks that much, so we made her come here.
I forgot about that. She doesn't like Starbucks.
Yeah, she likes Tim Hortons.
So this week, we are going to continue the story of Joseph. Last week, what happened last week, Tim?
How he was sold into slavery, and his brothers hated him.
Yeah.
And all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So we're going to talk about that more this week.
Yeah, we're going to go into Joseph's story a little bit more.
Peep the church.
Peep the church, yep. So this week, so with Joseph's story, we're going to talk about, like, when things feel out of control, which, I mean, I'm not going to say it again this whole season, all this stuff. When things feel out of control, God is present. He doesn't always, like, instantly fix your problems, but we're going to talk about how it's important to understand and realize, like, hey, God is there with you. So we got some Starbucks, and now we are going to get some stuff for culture night. We're going to find a backdrop, and so you're gonna hang out with us.
I mean, it has fabric, but
they probably got a bunch of decoration.
And we're gonna look for the apple juice apple thing. And Jesse doesn't think the apple thing is real. The TikTok apple juice is real. I went to California and I tried it, and he still doesn't believe me. So we got to prove him wrong.
Capish?
I feel like the majority of this vlog is gonna be me talking to myself because the two adults are talking. All right, we're in Party City. She's on a mission. She's going into mom mode.
Okay. With Joseph, so last week we talked about how, yeah, he was sharing the story with his brothers, or his dream about them bowing down and them worshiping him, and like he was this big leader, and they got mad, understandably. Like,
ticked.
If my little sister did that, I'd be like, yeah, right. I'm going to show you, like, who's more powerful, and I don't know. I'll give you a nuggie or something. I'll
give you what for?
What for?
Yeah. What is that?
So we were talking about, like, family conflict and all that, like, how it's good for us to be contributors to our family. And so this week we wanted to talk about when Joseph was sold into slavery. Joseph was more favorable, and so they were angry and upset, and so what they did, like, they were so angry, they actually wanted to kill Joseph, which I've said that before, I wanted to kill a sibling, but I've never, like, actually thought about it, like, killing him. So they must have been super angry, like, super, there was a lot of bitterness, and then they ended up deciding to sell him into slavery, because that was nicer. But so they sell him into slavery, and they make it look like that Joseph died. They, like, grab his robe that his dad gave him, and they covered it in blood, like sheep's blood or an animal's blood, and then they gave it to their dad saying, like, oh, he died. In this moment, everything's out of control for Joseph. Like, there was literally nothing he could have done. maybe he could have kept his mouth shut a little bit more, but in this moment, like, his brothers threw him into slavery. There was nothing he could do. He totally felt out of control. And I think we can relate with Joseph, not to that severity, but in a lot of times it feels like there's a lot of things, Jesse, that we can't control, like the weather or like friend groups talking about us, like people talking bad about us, or the whole COVID thing and everything being canceled. There's a lot of stuff that we can't control. And in that situation, it's kind of scary. And you're like, all right, what do I do? And then you run to God, and then it seems like he's not there sometimes. Like he's not really like communicating to you back. And you're like, what the heck's going on? But something that Joseph realized, and it's something that we need to realize, is that God is present in your situation. He doesn't always fix it. He didn't pull Joseph out of slavery, which is interesting. Like, because probably Joseph was saying, like, okay, God, save me from like slavery or being away from my family, and God didn't pull him out, which he could have been like, oh, God, you're not there. But actually, God had a bigger plan. Just like in that situation, if life's out of control, but something that we need to realize is that God is present in your situation, even in the darkest situation. Even if you messed up, God is present. He's just as present in the good times as in the bad times. And sometimes that's extremely comforting, because I think we forget that God is there. When we don't hear him or we don't feel him, we're like, okay, God's gone. And actually, God is there in your messiest parts. And we have to remember that, because that can give us the strength to move forward and remember, like, all right, God has a plan. He's still here with me. There's a brighter future.
I know. See, I imagine it just being like throw up-y, like, oh, okay. Just look horrible.
Oh, it's got a Yankee Doodle feather.
Oh, I'll wear that. Maybe we should just go to Old Navy and get a bunch of American 4th of July stuff. Because that's where I would go for a kid.
Oh, yeah. I've got a pretty decent sized head, and this goes over my ears.
Get some healing.
We both have to wear them.
There's another one.
There's a different one?
Oh, that's a shirt.
Oh, I mean, come on, we're wearing those for sure.
We're in the hobby of Lobby. Trying to get a few more stuff for Culture Night.
We'll see if it's right.
We'll taste it. So, how can you...
I'm sorry to interrupt. Is that light both yellow and green at the same time up there? It definitely is, right? Yellow and green are both on. Now the yellow's still on. It's like the yellow's permanently on.
Yellow and red is on.
We're not making this up. This is the weirdest thing I've ever seen.
That is weird. I've never seen that. It's like I'm totally out of control.
It's like, I don't even know what to do.
I don't even know what to do when the yellow light is on constantly. But what I do know is that God is here. Come on for someone in the back. Yeah, but how can you, and something that maybe you feel anxious about or you're depressed about, or you're just like, it's just really hard to go through because you're not in control. How can you be mindful? Because that's really what it's all about. Being mindful that God is there with you. See what happens. Because Joseph did it, and he was enslaved. And that's like a little harder. So, and that gave him peace, and that really helped him. So how can we be mindful and remember, hey, God's here with me? It's going to be all good.
All right, y'all. Thanks for watching this week's episode. Remember, even when your life feels out of control, remember and be comforted by the fact that God is always with you, no matter what the situation is. Thanks for watching this week's episode. I don't know what number it is, 73 or something like that.
Yep.
We'll see you next week.
Peace.